Multimodality may sound like a scary word at first, but it's actually quite simple. Many of us are used to writing in an academic setting, but what many of us don't realize often enough is that we are using many of the same writing skills in other forms of communication and design in our daily lives. We are also subjected to these same strategies and styles just about everywhere around us. Multimodality plays a huge role in this all, and it essentially means having multiple modes of delivering information to an audience or audiences. The easiest way to think about this is through some examples we've all likely seen in the past. A children's book is one of the first experiences with this, especially children's books made for babies and toddlers. These often have interactive components of all kinds, such as buttons to press that emit sounds or play songs. The cow still goes moo, right? Sometimes they have flaps for children to open and discover something new beneath. There are images both moving and still all around, especially with today's technology. Perhaps some of them even have scratch and sniff components. The goal of all these strategies of delivering information to a child in as many modes as possible helps to reinforce knowledge, understanding, and learning. The more ways the same information is delivered, the stronger the memory will likely be. We see these same strategies in newspaper articles, both in print and online. Sometimes, frustratingly, these manifest in online advertisements, something we all likely find a bit irritating. This is especially true of the comic section, of course, but even the job listings section has links for interested parties to follow these days. This brings the experience out of the newspaper, even if it's just a physical copy. We see these same strategies in magazines of all types, including academic or just for fun. We read blogs, visit websites, follow recipes, learn new skills, and so many other things online, all providing multimodal experiences. For this course, you will be putting your creativity to the test. You must also remain open to thinking about and employing strategies and approaches that help engage both yourself and your audience on multiple levels. Remaining flexible and changing up your approach as you move through the writing process is also important. All of these help you employ your rhetorical knowledge and critical thinking skills, as well as reading and writing, in ways that will effectively impact your audience and help you make a real difference with your writing, even if that difference ends up being only a small change within your community. Some strategies for multimodal components to utilize within all aspects of your assignments in this course could include the following. Perhaps on your digital portfolio, you could provide or create a YouTube video that helps to introduce your audience to the type of content contained within that section. Perhaps you could enhance your course reflections by providing links, images, sound clips, and videos that could help enhance your reflections, provide further context, or simply immerse the reader in understanding your perspectives. Perhaps you could provide links or videos or sound clips within your project to help the reader understand your topic on multiple levels. In some cases, such as this student's, In some cases, such as this student's project, experiencing the world as experienced from the perspective of a deaf person can be difficult for the average reader to imagine. So sharing audio experiences that help immerse the reader in that world will assist them in fully understanding the topic and community. Whatever approach you decide to take, we do want you to use multimodal composition throughout the course. While we will create two official multimodal components, one for each of our major projects, we do want you to also employ multimodality within your digital portfolio, your course reflections, your discussion board posts, your written projects, and just about all other types of writing you may be doing in class. Sometimes multimodal components to an assignment may not make sense, so just use your best judgment and decide which methods will work best for the situation you are currently composing for. Most importantly, try to have fun with it too.